Hi friends, I'm Miss Nancy Ruth from Parent Road Ministries. Today, our workshop, we're going to talk about how to start new habits and routines. So this time of year, everybody's talking about doing these things, but it's the end of January and some of us are kind of stuck and what we planned isn't working. So how do we get these habits to actually stick? That's what we're going to talk about in today's workshop.
Hi, I'm Miss Nancy Ruth. I'm a children's minister and the co-founder of Parent Road Ministries. We want to see kids living for Jesus.
I have my notes on my phone here, so I'm going to make sure I don't forget anything. All right, so here we have. So here we have six steps to creating new habits and routines that actually work. All right. There's a couple habits we're going to kind of thread through this. One is, believe it or not, took me over 20 years, but I'm finally developing a coffee habit. It took me a long time to actually like coffee. Now I do. So I'm trying to drink that every morning. But often I'll be sitting down to breakfast and haven't gotten my vitamins and everything and sit down and, oh, I forgot to make the coffee. And then you get up and make the coffee. By the time I get back to my cereal, it's soggy. So I'm trying to build that in earlier in my routine. So that's one habit. The other one we're going to talk about is developing the habit of a daily Bible study. But this can really apply to any habit. All right, first thing you have to do is decide what you want to do. A lot of people do that in January. This year I'm going to do this, or this is going to be my word of the year, and so how are you going to apply that? Okay, so we're going to look at our two habits. So decide, what habit or routine do you want to start? Okay, second step is to observe what you're already doing. So like with my coffee example, when I get up in the morning, first thing I do is take a shower, and then as I come into the kitchen, I'm in my kitchen, so as I come into my kitchen, I immediately go this way, and I get two bowls out of the cupboard, one for my cereal and a smaller one for my vitamins. Then I go into the pantry, and I pour my cereal in and load up my vitamins, and I bring it back over here, I put the vitamins on the table, and then I go and I put nuts and cranberries on my cereal and put it down. And then I fill up my water bottle to make sure I'm ready to take my vitamins. And then I bring, once I'm all set with the spoons and everything, then I bring the milk in and pour it because I like my cereal crispy. I don't like it soggy. Okay, then usually is when I go, oh wait, I forgot the coffee. So then I have to come back over here and turn on the kettle so that I can make my coffee. So this is when you're coming up with what you're already doing, okay, and where you want to insert this in your day, you're not passing judgment on what you're doing, you're just observing and writing down what is actually happening, not what you would like to happen, but what actually happens, okay? One other thing that I'm trying to do is move when I have my daily Bible study, and I'm trying to move it to, well, I'm still trying a couple different things, but one thing I'm trying is doing it at breakfast. Okay, and I don't want to get through breakfast and have to leave for work and went, oh, I meant to do my Bible study at breakfast. Okay, so that's the other thing I'm trying to insert in there, at least try that slot in my day. All right, so we decided what we're going to do. Now, one of the reasons we track this, and if you're a homeschool mom or parent, then you usually have a schedule of the day, right? And you say what you do when and in what order. Okay, the benefit of this is you can do what's called habit stacking. So you look at the habits you already have in place, and then you say, now I want to insert my new habit right here between these two. And so one of the main things you need to do to develop a new habit is to find a trigger. A trigger is just what's going to remind you to do it, all right? So in the habit stacking, I need to find a place earlier in my get ready and have your breakfast routine to start the kettle so that my coffee's ready when I sit down with my breakfast. So, one of the things I also do in a different part of my day that can help is in the evening before I go to bed, I lay out what I'm going to wear the next day. And I kind of get things ready, my bag ready to go to work so I don't have to think in the morning because my brain doesn't turn on that early in the morning. Okay, so I decided to try something new and it seems to be working when I remember to do it. When I lay out my clothes and get things ready, I'm putting my coffee cup on the table right where I see it, because as I come into the kitchen, the table is right here, and so I can see the coffee cup and go, I gotta turn the kettle on, and then I can go get my bowl and get those things ready. Then by the time I sit down, the kettle is usually starting to whistle. I move a little slowly in the morning, so starting to whistle, and it goes, oh yeah, so that I can get my creamer and get ready and have my coffee when I sit down before I pour the milk so my cereal is crispy. Okay, one of the other things that can help with this habit of inserting the Bible study in there, when I'm sitting down at breakfast, is a great time for me to read. I like to read when I'm at the table if there's not people around that I want to talk to. And typically my dad goes to have coffee at my sister's house, so he's not even here when I eat my breakfast. So I thought this is perfect. So in the evening when I lay out my clothes, put my coffee cup on the table, and I put my Bible on the table right next to where I have my breakfast, so that it's a reminder to me when I sit down and I see that, oh yeah, I need to read my Bible while I'm here at breakfast. Okay? So look for where you can insert it and look for that habit stacking, things you could build on top of. See, if I was just trying to remember at some point in the day to put my Bible out or my coffee cup out, that wouldn't really work. But if I link it in my mind to grabbing my clothes and laying them out for the next day, then it becomes one on top of the other and one reminds me of the next. And that's what habit stacking is, and it's a great thing. Okay, so we have our trigger, what's going to remind me. It could be an alarm, it could be a time of day, it could be when the kids come home from school, it could be before when you sit down before you start your homework, that might be a good time to read your Bible, or any of these kinds of things. When you get back from an outing and you're ready to, something you do every day, like if you go, I have a friend who goes for a walk every day with her daughter, maybe when you get back from your walk you can read your Bible together, or any of those things. So find a trigger. Next step is to make it easy to take action. This comes from a book called Atomic Habits. I'll have to put the author on the screen because I can't remember who it is at the moment. But his example was running. Okay, so if you're gonna run first thing in the morning, then when you get up, you're tired in the first place. You don't really wanna go out in the cold and run. So what you need to do is make it easier to take action. So if you have your running clothes out and your shoes out right there beside the bed, so when you get up, it's all right there, you're removing excuses and making it easier to take action. That's also what I'm doing when I put my coffee cup out and when I put my Bible on the table. So I don't have to have that added step of sit down, eat my breakfast, oh, my Bible's over there, oh, I have to get up and get it, but then my cereal will get soggy and I'm making all these excuses and not doing it when I wanted to do it. So take away those excuses and make it easy to take action. All right, next step. Like I said, I don't forget anything. Oh, reward. Okay, this is what I find challenging. All right, so a habit is really just a trigger, what reminds you to take action and you know, prompts you to do that. The action itself and the reward. What's tricky about the reward is you have to find out what actually motivates you. Okay, maybe in your house you have a sticker chart and a reward at the end of the week if you get all your stickers. That's awesome. Maybe you have some other kind of reward. Typically my reward in the past has been like a sweet or a treat to eat, but I'm trying not to eat as much sugar, so that's not a good motivator anymore because it kind of negates another thing I'm trying to do. All right, so I've been trying to rack my brain and figure out what actually motivates me. What actually gets me excited about doing something? Because let's be honest, even if you know it has value, like reading the Bible, there are some days you just don't feel like it. And you need something to help motivate you to do it anyway. Because when you're reading God's Word, you'll get a blessing, even on the days you don't really want to, if you're faithful and do it. So I've been trying to figure this out. And I've been playing around. I discovered I'm using a program called Trello to track. I actually have two jobs and track all the stuff I'm doing. And I recently discovered when I put the things I need to do this week in a particular list, and by the end of the week, if that list is empty, I have the best feeling ever, and I can actually take my day off and enjoy it and not feel guilty and not feel pressured to be working when I'm actually resting and all those kinds of things. It's amazing. Now, even if I don't actually finish the list, I reschedule it for the next week, a certain day the next week, so I know when it'll get done. So it's not that I actually finish everything each week, but I am trying to make that list realistic every week, and that helps too. Anyway, the point of all that is, I found that that empty list really motivates me. I will go that extra effort at the end of the week when I'm tired to finish what's on that list, just to see that list empty before I go into my day off. I'd love it. So one of the things that might help me, and I'm playing around with this, is having a list of things I do. I just created a new list for today. So I have the weekly list, and I just recently created a list for today. So now I get that not just once a week, but every day. If I can clear that list, oh, I can take the night and relax and watch a show with my dad and not worry. Doesn't always happen, but I try. You know how life goes. All right, so maybe on that list I can put things like Bible study on there. And it's not the same as homework. It's not the same as a to-do list you need to do. It's, you know, more important. But isn't it so true that sometimes the important things get shoved aside because of all the urgent things and the busyness that we have in life? So it's trying to find ways to bring that back front and center. So for me, maybe it's putting it on the list, and by the end of the day when I've done it, I can say, yes, I've done it, and my list is clear. Okay? You have to find what motivates you. Is it the sticker chart? Is it a special treat? Is it a chance to go visit your favorite park or something at the end of the day? Is it a bubble bath? Is it, you just have to find out what motivates you and come up with a good reward for doing it. Eventually, doing your habit will create its own reward. We see this a lot in food and cravings. Like with my coffee, the reward is not necessarily the caffeine, although I am using it for the caffeine. The actual reward is the taste of the creamer. I love my creamer. It's nothing fancy, it's just French vanilla, but it's amazing. So that's my reward for making my coffee every day, is that sweet treat of the creamer in my coffee. Still don't really like the taste of coffee, but a lot of creaming, you can't even taste the coffee. Okay. So we have the main parts of the habit. We're going to review. Decide what you want to do. Observe what you already do. Find a trigger, something to remind you to take action. Make it easy to take action. Find a reward, what motivates you. 6 is evaluate and tweak as needed. Okay? If you've done this for a week and you find out this is not working, find out what you need to change in your system. Or try it a little bit different. Just tweak your system and see if you can get it to work. Just keep playing with it till you find what does work. All right, I have some cautions for you before I let you go, okay? Number one, this is a real danger in January. Don't go in and say, I'm going to change everything right now. You're going to fail, I'm sorry. Stop, back up, take the long-term view. Change one thing at a time. If you have a lot of habits you want to change and develop and tweak or start with one at a time, and then slowly add. You have a much better chance of success that way. Okay? Second caution, there we go. Be very careful of self-sabotage. I am really good at this, okay? So you set yourself up, and you had this ideal plan of what you're gonna do in the day, and these new habits you're gonna do every day, and how it's gonna work, and you have this perfect plan, and then life happens, and it didn't work. I have a great plan to get up. I keep going back and forth with this because I so much want to do it and I can't yet. I want to get up early in the morning. I keep going back and forth between 5 and 5:45 in the morning to get up. Then I can do all these things to set my day off right and get a good start for the day. Then I'm ready and I can do my work and then take some time off in the evenings and it's great. Okay, so I plan out my week, I plan my routines, and you know, and habit stacking and all those kinds of stuff, and then I can't sleep at night, or something happens and it messes up my evening, and I'm still struggling trying to find a good evening routine that makes me actually want to sleep when it's time to sleep. Okay, so these things happen, and then your alarm goes off and nope, didn't hear it. Backup alarm goes off, nope, didn't hear it, and you wake up 2 hours late. I gotta get to work. So forget the evening routine. It's quick, brush your teeth, change clothes, grab something to go on the way, grab your coffee, and get to work and get started. And then the whole day's off. Okay, so be realistic. Watch what happens as you go. And I'm trying to do this myself. I've backed off on what I'm trying to do in the morning, and I'm really focusing on trying to develop that evening routine that tells my body it's time to sleep. Okay? And don't be afraid to change your plan as you go. One of the things I've had to learn, and I'm still trying to figure out how to incorporate better, build in cushion time. You can't have every second of the day planned. And if you're a planner like I am, it's very easy to have your day all planned out, but then the unexpected happens, or someone needs help, or you know, something takes a whole lot longer than you thought it did. And you need to take the time to do that. But then your whole week is scheduled so jam-packed, where are you going to make up the time? So include a little buffer time in your schedule as well. All right, let me just double check my notes here. Also think through, related to that, think through how much time something actually takes. I'm really good at like I said, scheduling things out, but I'm not good at figuring out exactly how long things should take. Because in my idea, this should only take 15 minutes, and then it takes 25 or 30. Consistently, like every day. And every day I'm going, but this should only take 15 minutes. And I have it in my head so much that it should only take 15 minutes that I'm not willing to tweak and change and adapt this routine I'm trying to develop. Don't get in that habit. I have to remind myself of that constantly. Be realistic about the time it takes. Let's see. And think through that unexpected, like I said. All right? I do wish you the best with the habits you're developing. And if you're working on a daily Bible study habit, that's wonderful. And remember, the Lord wants us to spend time with Him. That means He will equip us and He will give us that hunger to be in His Word. And we should pray and ask for that. And if the new habits and routines we're trying to develop are pleasing to the Lord and we've sought His face and said, Lord, what do You want me to do with my time? Show me what I need to change to be better pleasing to You. He will honor that and help us. I love you, friends, and I'll see you next time.